Hi kids, welcome back to the Whitey the White Guy Show. I'm Whitey, this is Cracker, and today we're going to review the film Ghost Ship, starring Ron Eldard, Carl Urban.
There's Gabriel Byrne's in it. There's a lot of recognizable people. Yeah. Gabriel Byrne's in it, Juliana Margulies from ER, Desmond Harrington from Dexter.
Yes, I'm glad you brought him up. I love that guy.
In Dexter, I hated his fucking guts in Dexter.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I like him as an actor.
Yeah.
I think he's a very good actor. So, do you want me to do the synopsis? You want
no. The basic plot of this is Gabriel Byrne is the leader of, I guess you would say, an excavation crew.
It's a salvage crew.
Salvage crew.
Desmond Harrington played Quinn on the TV show Dexter.
That's who we're talking. I call him Detective Douche.
He had a really small role in Boiler Room. And when he meets he introduces himself to this salvage crew while they're at a bar celebrating that they just salvaged this one ship and made a bunch of money.
Mm-hmm.
And then he says, he shows them pictures. He says, there's a pilot who's going to fly over and I saw this massive ship.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what it is, but here's where it is. And then they're sitting there bartering over a percentage and he takes his 10%, but he says, but I'm going with it. The really good premise that is okay.
Mm-hmm.
But I like Ron Eldard, I like Carl Urban, I like Desmond Harrington, and there's somebody else in this. He wasn't actually in it. I thought he saw him, but wasn't. So I'm an actors guy.
Mm-hmm.
So I like those actors. So, but I thought it kind of
lost steam.
It went for a home run and it got a double.
You think it is
a good film. It is a solid film, and think of it. You discover this old ship and you walk around the ship. And everything is aged, and everything looks like it's been floating around the ocean for 40 years.
I thought the set design was
great.
The
set design was great. The mood is great. I just thought, didn't quite. It tried to get dark without getting too dark.
Mm-hmm.
It tried to get gory, but still be kind of fun gory. Mm-hmm. It wasn't depressing set.
Right.
And when that many people die.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can go too dark and be depressing as opposed to fun, which is what the film is supposed to be.
And see, what about...
This is a film where somebody had three or four ideas and then just incorporated it all. So a lot of shit's happening. But...
It seemed like it was...
Well, really quick, though, with the black guy we're talking about, somebody, Washington. Isaiah Washington, they really didn't develop characters a lot. His character was a bit underdeveloped. And there's a few things where you can see, like, him and Ron Eldard had a little bit of a conflict, and it's like, it just happens and it's gone.
Yeah.
You know, so there was something, you know, the characters are a bit underdeveloped, and I think the Ron Eldard and the Carl Urbans and the Harringtons.
Desmond
Harringtons, they can come in with, they stood out as with comparative little dialogue to go on. Create characters that you care about.
Oh, yeah.
About.
What?
The other people weren't able to create characters that really pulled me.
Mm-hmm.
They weren't bad, but they weren't good, where in the little time they had to create characters. Because that's, when you got an action film and a horror film, you don't have a lot of dialogue to get to know you. I gotta like you right away, because we're gonna kill you soon.
Well, the thing is, the characters...
I don't think they did a good job.
Juliana Margulies, she was decent for what she was
fine.
Given.
She was fine.
Carl Urban and... I can't... Ron
Elder.
There you go. They're the comic relief, and they're the buddy buddy guys, and I think it works.
You like them.
They're very likable.
And that's acting.
Like there's a time when you know
they are acting at this level. Oh, I'm out of breath. They're acting at this level, and everybody else was down here.
Like one of my favorite scenes has nothing to do with ghosts to begin with. It's when they're opening all the canned goods.
Hold on.
And
they're acting at this level. Everybody else is down here, and down here is Bob Saget.
90% likable characters. I really like the effects. I somewhat saw the twist coming at the end, but the reasoning behind it I thought was neat.
Yep.
I really
yeah, it's neat. Really? Is that it?
But the thing is, he's a recovering alcoholic, but then you throw in ghosts and then I'm like, that's The Shining right there.
Yeah, he's
Nicholson without going crazy.
Yeah, there's quite a bit going on. You can see that they trimmed it down.
Mm-hmm.
And so to give you that quick, fun, action-y hour and a half. So, It wasn't a movie to make 2 hours long and develop the characters. No. So I think they made the best film they're going to make. It's a fucking ship.
Mm-hmm.
It's got ghosts on it. But it's ghost ship.
Given what they were, given they what they job. Had, I yeah. think they did a decent they job. They
did a good job with that premise. Mm-hmm. It was spooky. It was creepy. Good set. Good tone. Mm-hmm. It's just not a home run. It's a solid, okay movie.